if I stall on my test, will I fail? The answer to that question is not necessarily. If I stall at the beginning of the test, as I'm moving off from a parking bay or from the side of the road, I'm not interfering with anybody, it's not gonna be a fail. So I'm now in gear three, do all my observations around the car, I've gotta move off, and that happens. First thing is brake, clutch down, I've got the car secure, get the engine running, check my gear, back in gear one, and I'm ready to go. If I stall trying to emerge from a junction and there's a car coming, the chances of you failing your test are pretty high. So welcome to Top Tips Tuesdays, although it's Wednesday. Slight branding issue there. I am gonna be putting myself on the line. I'm gonna be putting myself in a few situations
for you
where I'm going to stall
for you,
and I'm gonna show you how I recover. So the first thing I've gotta do is be able to make sure my head's focused on what it is that I need to do. If we can concentrate on the task in hand instead of panicking.
Run!
Which I know is a lot easier to say than actually to do, but you could practice it. And I've done this before. I've actually got some of my pupils to stall on purpose. They prove to themselves that they can actually get out of it. And that might actually be something worth doing, considering stalling on tests is quite a high possibility because of all the stress and the tension of actually doing a test in the first place. The second thing I've got to do is make sure that I've got the car under control. If the car is rolling backwards, you make sure that it's not. The third thing I've got to do is I've got to get the engine running. And the fourth thing I need to do is check that I'm in the correct gear so that I can then move off nice and fluidly. Put it in the wrong gear. So I'm now in gear three. I'm doing my observations on the junction. I got to move off and I stall. First thing, recover the vehicle, make sure that I've got the car under control. Get the engine running, check my gear, I'm back in gear one, I'm doing my observations on the junction. If you're still rolling, it's possible to get the car going again. Here I am, I'm behind a bus, and let's say for example I'm coming to a stop, I stick it in gear three, I go to move off, and as I move off I stall, clutch goes straight down, I'm actually rolling. Here I start the engine again, I check what gear I'm in, I check all three mirrors and I drive on. Stalling, I have to tell you this, right? Stalling, even after you pass your test, is still going to happen. We all feel a bit stupid when we stall. You could be distracted, you could be having a conversation with somebody, you might forget what gear you're in. It just happens from time to time. There's nothing we can do about it. This is driving a manual car. I go to move off and I stall. I don't stall. Damn it. I think secretly I didn't really want to stall there. You see, I feel silly doing it. If you're getting any value out of this video, hit that like button because it really, really helps the channel and spreads the message out to anybody else that may be interested in this content. Really do appreciate it if you do. Here we are, I'm in a situation, I'm at a set of traffic lights. I've got a van directly behind me. I stick it in gear three again. Seems to be a common fault, this one. Keep sticking it in gear three. If I keep doing that, then I need to start paying attention to my gears. I'm waiting for the lights to change. Let's see how quickly I can recover from this stall. It's very possible that he may start beeping me. But if he does, keep your head under control. Get the car moving. Think about your processes with the clutch. Double check the gear. And we should be okay. Lights change and I stall. So clutch down, brake, restart the engine, check my gear, all three mirrors, drive on. I was only there for a couple of seconds. He didn't beat me. He didn't beat me. Now that was a really quick recovery. If you can recover a stall like that, that would just be a minor fault. If I was stuck there for ages and the examiner had to help me out, that would be a bigger problem. The reasons why I've been stalling in this video have been all about gear. Now, if clutch is the reason, then you obviously need to go and practice that. Now, I'll put a link to a video on how to control the clutch up here somewhere. So there's gonna be a link somewhere across the top of your screen there. If you wanna know more about clutch, follow that link and it will help you to improve your clutch control. That's not what this video is all about. If you keep stalling because of your gear as well, that's also a problem. You should also be working on gears. You don't wanna be going to your test if you keep sticking it in gear three every time you're moving off. But if you like what you've seen here, hit that like button, subscribe, and then you'll know when the next video is coming out. And in the meantime, I'll see you in the next one. Oh, that was the end of That was the end of Top Tips Tuesdays, probably being released on a Wednesday. because I got serious branding issues. If anyone out there's got really good with branding and wants to help me with that, then hit me up. DM me in some way. I don't even know what DM me. Direct message me. Direct message me on something, Instagram or even on the comments below. Any comments, if you have any comments or if there's anything you want to see, Top Tips Tuesdays. Eventually will be coming out on Tuesdays. Top Tips Tuesdays. If there's anything that you want to see and you want me to record, you're having a problem with, then let me know. Hit me in the comments and I'll do it for you. I'll make a video for you. Why is that even on? I thought that video was off. I thought that camera was off. I thought that video camera, I can't speak anymore. Anyway, get wheel out. So Top Tips Tuesdays, hooray, yeah.